Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this Batman versus Twitter logo animation in PowerPoint 2016. Here I have this Batman logo, and if I hover my mouse over the Batman, then it converted to the Twitter logo, and when I move the mouse outward, then it reverses back. And this animation has been accomplished just in two slides, and it is a very simple animation. And in this presentation I have used the morph effect, whereas I have another presentation here. Here you can see that I have accomplished the same animation in three slides, and that is the without morph effect. As you can see that no transitions has been applied on any of the slide, but if I show you the slideshow, then you will see the same effect here, just like the morph effect. And finally I have a third slide, and you can see that Batman versus Twitter without morph, PowerPoint stupidity. And why I am calling that, let me show you. Here you can see that I have three slides, and on each slide, if I here apply the shape outline color, let's say this one, then you can see that I have drawn a circle around the Batman logo. That is because what I want, when I move my mouse over the circle here, then I want an action to run, and that action will be mouse over hyperlink to next slide, and the next slide will be this one, second one. And here on the second slide, if I apply the shape outline again, then I have drawn a slide size rectangle here, and here I also applied an action, and that will be on next slide, the third one. And on the third slide, what I want, again I have drawn a circle here, and again another action has been applied, and that will be, what I want here is to move back to the second slide. But why I called it PowerPoint stupidity, because if I run the slideshow from the first slide, and when I move my mouse over the circle, then it moves to the next slide with the animation, and when I move my mouse outwards, then it reverses back to the Batman logo. But what you can see here, let me show you the slideshow again. That is the first slide, and when I move my mouse over the logo, then it converted to the Twitter, and when I move outward, then it reverses back to Batman. But again, when I move back to the Batman logo, then the Twitter logo appears immediately without any effect. So that is why I called it PowerPoint stupidity, because when you apply actions in PowerPoint, let's say on this circle I have applied an action, and that is hyperlink to next slide when mouse over. What PowerPoint did is it moves to the next slide, and again it moves to the third slide, but when I hover my mouse over the circle here on the third slide, then it reverses back to the second slide. But what the problem here is that you can see that I have applied a spin animation to the logo, but when it make a loop in between the slides, it doesn't show the animation. That is why I called it stupidity of PowerPoint, because I am seeing this error from past many years and they have done nothing about that. I mean, when you apply actions throughout the slides, then it repeats the actions but doesn't repeat the animations that you have applied on the slide. And here I have the third slide without morph, and here you can see that I have applied the same action commands on this slide as well, but instead of using hyperlinking to next slide, I am using custom shows for this presentation particularly. So let's get started, and I will begin with this one. And let me tell you one thing here, that I have drawn outer circles and rectangles here to apply the action command, and you must remember that this logo has been drawn using the shape tool, and that is the Freeform shape tool. this one, and you can use this shape tool to draw the shapes you like, just like that. And you have to later use the edit point command to make it more realistic, just like this. And later you have to use edit shape, edit point command to make this more attractive, like this. Okay, so how you can accomplish this animation using the morph command? So let me tell you what you have to do. Let me hide this circle here. So on the first slide, go to the transitions tab and apply the morph effect. Set the timing you want. I am applying 0.25 seconds, or you can also apply half a second duration of this morph effect. So here on the second slide, you also need to apply the morph command, and I am applying the timing, half a second timings. If I run the slideshow, then you can see that when I hover over the Batman, then it changed to the Twitter logo, and when I move my mouse outwards, then it reverts back to the Batman logo. That is how it works. And another thing is, here is insert action, and here I am, what I am doing is, on mouse over, what I want is to move to the next slide, and on the next slide I have applied the same action, and this time I am saying it to move back to the previous slide. That how easy it is to create this kind of animation, but that is only possible if you have the morph command. So if you don't have morph transition in your PowerPoint 2016 or any other version of PowerPoint, then you can use the second technique, this one. And on this slide, what I am doing is, let me show you the slideshow. So what you have to do here is, you have to create custom slideshow. And for that, go to the slideshow tab, and here click on custom slideshow, custom shows. And here you can see that I have created two separate custom shows here, Twitter second slide, Batman third slide. And here let me open the animation pan, and you can see that I have applied an animation here, that is the spin animation, which is rotating this logo to 100 degree clockwise, and hit the OK key. And on the third slide, you can see that it is moving the logo to 100 degree counterclockwise. It means back to its original position, and it is looping between these two slides, second and third one. Because I have shown you in this presentation that PowerPoint does not run the animation if you make a loop using the actions. So what I did here is, I created two separate custom slideshow using the custom slideshow command in slideshow tab. And here what I did, I created a new custom show, named it like Twitter, and added the second slide to it. Hit the OK key. And then again I created another custom show and name it Batman, and added the third slide to it. And why I am doing this? Because if you use custom shows through the actions, then it will let you run the animations that you have applied. So let me remove these two. So what you can do here, you can move to the first slide, select the Batman logo, click the action button, on mouse over, hyperlink to custom show. And here choose the show that you want to run when you move your mouse over the logo. And I want the Twitter second slide to appear when I hover my mouse over the Batman. Hit the OK key. And don't forget to apply show and return option, so it will run the animations that you will apply on the logos. That is the spin animation. Hit the OK key. OK. And on the second slide, what I am doing, as you can see that on the first slide, there is no animation, and I want to make a loop between second and third slide, because here we have the spin animation on both of these slides. So on the second slide, what I will do is, I will select this outer box here, which is hidden because I have applied no outline. So I will select this rectangle here, go to the insert, action, and what I want to do is to, on mouse over, I want to hyperlink it to custom show, and that will be Batman third slide. I want to move the show to the, I want PowerPoint to show the next slide through custom show, and make a check mark on show and return, hit the OK key. And finally, on the third slide, select this outer circle here, which is hidden because of no outline. And then go to the insert, action, mouse over, hyperlink to custom show. And this time, Twitter, show and return. And that way, it will make a loop between second and third slide through the custom shows. Hit the OK key and let's see the slideshow. And here when I will move my mouse over the Batman logo, it will run the custom show of the Twitter slide. And when I will move my mouse outwards, then it will run the custom show of third slide, that is Batman. So it will make a loop between these slides through the custom show. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your comments. And don't forget to hit the like button and do share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and have a great day. And this animation is inspired by one of the animation by Marina Brito at codepen.io website.